Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video let's talk about how we can style our components, right? Because it has an inbuilt CSS module support. Before we go ahead, we can also talk about the previous video where we were just using this get server side props, and we are able to see the output something like this. We are able to make the API call, and this is the data we are getting from the blog post, and we are showing it on the UI. Okay. Now let's talk about the global styles first. Okay, in the app.js you can see we have declared something like this. So if you wanted to put some styles which are global to the application, then you can create a styles, put global CSS here, and then that CSS you can include in underscore app.js. This is the way to include the global styles throughout your application. So whatever you are adding in underscore app.js, that will be available global to your application. Okay, you can also import things from node modules, like import if you are getting something from the bootstrap dist, there is some particular path css and bootstrap dot min dot css, something like this. This also you can import in underscore app.js, because this style will be available throughout your pages in the application. Okay, we already talked about the CSS modules, like you create a components. Inside the component, we can create a, like you are creating a button component. And button.js is nothing but a simple button component. Let's for now just put any dummy content. And here we have button dot style button dot module dot css, right? Now how can you import this button styles in your button component is, go to your button.js. I mean, this thing is also available in the documentation. So now if you wanted to apply the styles, you can see styles dot container. Okay, this styles dot container is already applied. So the styles is available here. We already have home module.css which is already supporting these CSS modules. So what we have done is, you will see these like a JavaScript objects, container, main and all, right? Once you import them, then you can access it using dot operator. So here if you see, I'm importing it in the styles. Just for an example, we can use this only styles dot container main title, and these are nothing but a classes names. So you need to put a class name and styles dot main. So what will be applied here, this styles will be applied on that particular div tag. Okay, so these are the built-in CSS support. You can create a CSS modules, and you can actually import the dot module dot CSS is an extension. This is the fixed extension we have to use, and if you are using this kind of extension, then while doing a build time, you will get a separate bundle. If I try to say this, you will create a separate chunks for CSS. Okay, SES support is also there. You can install npm install SES, and you just need to modify our next config.js. Let's do this. We can just need to add options, SES options, next config we can create on the root. It is next.config.js, and in that you just need to provide the path of SES. So inside a styles of your folder, you can actually create .ses file, CSS files. Okay, and then you just define all your SES definitions here. It will be come in the path of bundling. You can also use less and stylus. For that you have to use external modules, how to do them. Okay, CSS in JS we are already using. So what we are doing is styles JSX and global styles. CSS in JS is a concept where using which we can achieve a single page component. I think I can modify this component. What we can do is, we can write something like this, and here we are using JSX. So we are putting CSS in JS. because it is getting compiled into JavaScript component. And here JSX, if you wanted to put something in the global, then put a global JSX. Okay, this is how we are able to add the styles for our components.